Workspaces let us organize our team and our sites. So as my fake team I've invented for this video grows, my Webflow workspace grows with me. In this lesson, we'll explain how to create a workspace, how to add seats to your workspace, we'll go over roles and permissions, and finally, we'll talk about how to manage your sites within your workspace. Let's jump right in and create a new workspace. Here, when we hover over, we can see our current workspaces. Yours might look different. In fact, you may only have the starter workspace that everyone gets by default. You can always easily add more seats to that, or you could already have a lot. I have several.
Remember, none of those are real.
But to create, to add a new workspace, we can go to Create Workspace. From here, we can select our plan and choose how many seats we want. And we can easily add or remove seats later. But that's where I can create workspaces. Next up is what I just talked about, adding or removing seats. From any of my workspaces, I'm here in my workspace, let's go into the workspaces settings. And from settings, let's find the members tab. From here, since we're viewing this as the workspace owner, we see an overview of how many members we have. And we can also add seats to invite new members to our workspace. We can manage the number of seats. I want to add like 70, and then I can continue to add these new seats to my workspace. When I do, I can of course send little invites to each and every person, which I'm typing right now. And I'm done. That's adding more seats to your workspace. This leads us to our next step, managing roles and permissions. And the only thing to note here is that we have roles and permissions for our workspace, and of course roles and permissions for each site. And roles and permissions for workspaces go like this. Members of a workspace can access all the sites and invite other workspace members. Admins can do all that, but they can also take care of the workspace billing. They can set roles and permissions on other members, and they can even remove workspace members, like Sarah, who's wreaking havoc over my newly created workspace right now.
No, well, I can't.
Okay.
I don't have my laptop, and my phone has been on a monitor the whole time.
Likely story.
Yeah. And I'm also not even here.
Sarah? And the workspace owner can do all of that. Plus, they can delete the workspace itself. What about at the site level? Well, for any given site in my workspace, because I'm the workspace owner, I'm automatically a site admin on all of these sites. But I can make other people site admins. They can transfer site ownership, they can control site billing, they can make site settings changes, and they can even change the weather. But I can also limit these permissions. For instance, I can make it so certain people can only design and publish a site. Or I can make someone a can't design only role, which is perfect if you have someone on your team that purposely messes with your site design for attention. But there's one more kind of role to cover before we move on. In Webflow, we also have the Webflow editor. This is the content-only interface we can share with other people who don't necessarily need access to things like styling or interactions or the assets panel, where yes, I do keep several styled photos of my face. But as a site admin, I can also add what I like to call guest editors, which is coincidentally exactly what they're called in Webflow. And guest editors can access the Webflow editor. They can go in and edit content. And I can even give them access to edit and publish. Again, I control all of this from the Members tab in my site settings. But that's roles and permissions at the workspace level and roles and permissions at the site level. Let's move on to our final section, managing our sites. Site admins can transfer sites between workspaces and other people. And since I'm the workspace owner and by default a site admin, I've got the permission to make the transfer. Let's go to our site settings and find our transfer icon. Here, we can either transfer to another workspace or to another user. In our case, we're going to transfer this site to a different workspace that we're also a part of. We're just selecting the workspace we want to transfer our site to and we'll click transfer. That's it. Now, if I'm also a member of the workspace I'm transferring it to, I should be able to head on over to that workspace and well, this is embarrassing. I seem to have lost my internet connection. But what you would see if I didn't lose my connection is this. So it goes here. But that's it. We created a workspace. We added seats to our workspace. We looked at roles and permissions on a workspace level and at the site level. And finally, we demonstrated how to manage your sites by transferring a site to another workspace. That's workspaces and roles and permissions in Webflow.